Please stand if you're able for the confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever.
Amen.
Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Gracious God,
have mercy on us. We confess that we have turned from you and given ourselves into the power of sin. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things we have done and things we have failed to do. Turn us again to you and uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life.
God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin and made us alive together with Christ. By grace, you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Amen. grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Let us pray. O God, on this day you revealed your Son to the nations by the leading of a star. Lead us now by faith to know your presence in our lives, and bring us at last to the full vision of your glory, through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first reading is from Isaiah, the 60th chapter. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look around. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from far away, and your daughters shall be carried on their nurses' arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be brought to you. The wealth of the nations shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you. The young camels of Midian and Ephah, and all those from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm today is Psalm 72, verses 1 through 7 and 10 through 14. We will read responsibly. Give the king your justice, O God, and your righteousness to the king's son.
That he may rule your people righteously and the Lord of justice.
That the mountains may bring prosperity to the people and the hills in righteousness. May he live as long as the sun and moon endure from one generation to another.
Let him come down like rain upon the mown field, like showers that water the earth.
In his time may the righteous flourish, and let there be an abundance of peace till the moon shall be no more.
May the kings of Tarshish and the Isles pay tribute, and the kings of Sheba and Seba offer gifts.
May all kings bow down before him, and all the nations do him service.
For the king delivers the poor who cry out in distress, the oppressed and those who have no helper.
He has compassion on the lowly and poor, and preserves the lives of the needy.
From oppression and violence he redeems their lives, and precious is their blood in his sight.
The second reading is from Ephesians. This is the reason that Paul, I am a prisoner for Christ Jesus, for the sake of you Gentiles. For surely you have already heard of the commission of God's grace that was given me for you, and how the mystery was made known to me by revelation. As I wrote above in a few words, a reading of which will enable you to perceive my understanding of the mystery of Christ. In former generations, this mystery was not made known to humankind as it has been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit. That is, the Gentiles have become fellow heirs, members of the same body, and sharers in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. Of this gospel, I have become a servant according to the gift of God's grace that was given me by the working of his power. Although I am the very least of all the saints, this grace was given to me to bring the Gentiles the news of the boundless riches of Christ and to make everyone see what is the plan of the mystery hidden for ages in God who created all things. So that through the church, the wisdom of God in its rich variety might now be made known to the rulers and authorities in the heavenly places. This was in accordance with the eternal purpose that he has carried out in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whom we have access to God in boldness and confidence through faith in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel comes to us today from Matthew, the second chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated, and I invite our young friends forward for the children's sermon. Good morning, ladies. We're going to do a little test of what you can see. You ready? Yeah? I want you to sit right there and see how many stars you can see. Anybody have a number? Got a number. Who else has a number? There's two numbers. Who else has a number? Yeah, three people have a number. All right, on the count of three, I want you to tell me how many stars you saw. And you can each just say the number that you saw. Okay, one, two, three. You saw nine. Anybody see more than nine? Would you like to point to the stars you saw? Yes. Six, yep. And three on the tree that you can see from here. All right. All right. So which ones did you see? Did you see the one up there?
Yeah.
Did you see the one down there?
Mm-hmm.
That's crocheted. Did you see, where's the other one that you saw?
The one up there.
Okay. How about this one over here? Did you see this one?
No.
You want to come look? So we've got a star right over there, the crocheted one. There's another one. Mm-hmm.
Right here.
Absolutely. Is there one back there too? If you stand over here.
There's one back.
Oh, you do see it. Very good. Yeah. Yes. Yes, I do. So tell me, why are there so many stars?
Because there was a star when Jesus was born, and it was shining light over him when he was born.
Right. And so the stars remind us that there were other people that came looking for Jesus, right? And so his birth was pretty special because even a star came out, right? Y'all didn't see this one, though, did you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I kind of hid that from you. This is one of my favorite Christmas ornaments because it sparkles in the light. See? Do you see it sparkling?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And let's go into the center here. And so one of the things that the stars remind us of is the wise people that came to see him. Okay, let's all gather around the star right here. So that's one of the things that the stars remind us of. Another thing is that when we look around and we see stars, we can remember that Jesus is around us all the time, right? But the star also reminds us to gather around Jesus, just like I had you gather around this star. So when you see a star, those are the things you can remember that Jesus is so important in your life, that you want to gather around Jesus. You want to follow Jesus, right? But also that Jesus is around us all the time, right? Yeah. All right. Let's say a prayer. Dear Jesus.
Dear Jesus.
Thank you
for the star that
helps us remember
that helps us remember
to look for you around us.
To look for you around us.
And to gather around you.
And to gather around you.
Amen.
Amen.
Thanks for coming up. Have a good week. Thanks for coming up. Have a good week. Thanks for coming up. Have a good week. Let us pray. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and loving, thank you for revealing yourself to us. Thank you for the star that led people from afar. Thank you for this day, this moment in time where we can gather all together to worship you. And now may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable to you. Amen. There are two ways, at least, to tell the story of the wise men, of the three kings, of the three strangers. There are two ways to tell this story. One is shaped for the ears and hearts and minds of our children, and one better suited for the adults. Truth be told, I prefer the version of the three kings from my childhood. In a world that is so serious so much of the time, in a world that often is often so difficult, violent, unkind, inhumane, I seek the version of the story that is full of awe and wonder, splendor and mystery. I seek the version of the story that gives me hope and joy. I seek the version of the story that has these strangers seeking the star, looking far beyond this world to find meaning. I seek the version of this story that has the three strangers going on a trip, exploring, seeking a baby, this phenomenal, special, amazing fulfillment of prophecy from a far distant land and even a far distant religion. This is the story of three kings who came from afar bearing gifts for the newborn king. This version of the story testifies to the far-reaching, indeed, the global and cosmic impact of Jesus' birth. Even more, it witnesses to God's commitment to reach out to all the world with the good news of God's redeeming love. And I'm not the only adult that appreciates and needs to hear these things again. We love this story in part because of the mystery these three distant and somewhat exotic guests introduce into the story, and in part because of the beauty and fittingness of their gifts, the source of all our gift-giving at Christmas. This story has led to the wonderful Christmas carol, We Three Kings, and kind of a spin-off carol, like The Little Drummer Boy, which isn't such a bad idea when you think about it, because it draws attention to the fact that we all have something to give. And so this week, we could easily focus our attention on the gifts of the kings and ponder what gifts we might offer, what talents, what interests, what passions might we see as gifts from God that we now can offer to Jesus by giving them to those all around us, especially those in need. What are your particular gifts that you can share with the world? You have been blessed to be a blessing to the world. How is that going for you? But there's also another element to this story that often gets lost in the shuffle. It gets lost in the shuffle of our contemplation of the strangers from the East, the Magi. And the adults among us, the spiritually mature, we will notice the darker side of this gospel reading. We will notice that there's those notes of fear and opposition that accompany the birth of Jesus right from the start. Herod, after all, does not greet the news of a newborn king with joy, nor does he search for a gift to present the Messiah. Instead, Herod is afraid. And not just Herod, but all Jerusalem with him, it says in our reading. Why? Perhaps it is because the one thing the powerful seek more than anything else is to remain in power. Gone from Herod and his court is any notion of the kind of servant leadership prescribed and required by Israel's prophets. Gone is the memory that God placed them in their positions to serve rather than to be served. Herod seeks his own ends, and so he is immediately threatened by even the mere mention of another, and therefore rival, king. But perhaps it's also simply that the presence of these three magi and their quest for God's Messiah announces that the world is changing, that God is approaching, and that nothing can remain the same in the presence of God's Messiah. The arrival of these wandering astrologers signals that the reach of God's embrace is broadening considerably, that there is no longer insider and outsider, but that all are included in God's plan for salvation. This isn't a new theme in the faith story, since from the very beginning of the story, God promises to bless Abraham, that he may in turn be a blessing to the world. And now, with the birth, life, death, and resurrection of Jesus, all distinctions between people of different ethnicities and religions are dissolving. At least, that's what our New Testament teaches us, that Jesus has begun, that all are becoming one in Christ. Who knows what could change next? This is our glimpse of what the kingdom of God looks like. Inclusion and divisions between people resolving in peace, just like the lion and lamb lying down together. But this glimpse of the kingdom of God, these ideas are so radically different from the way the world works, most people react with great fear. Most people react with fear to any real world movement toward this kind of peace between all people. Whatever the cause, fear is a powerful thing. It's powerful for us, and it was powerful for Herod and the religious leaders. Fear pushes us to act, to do something, to respond, to react, to lash out and find some way to relieve our fear. So in response to their fear, Herod, along with the chief priests and the scribes, conspire to find the Messiah and kill him. They will not succeed this time, but much later in the story, there will again be an unholy alliance between the political and religious leaders of the day, who will not only conspire against Jesus, but this time they will capture him, they will crucify him. And what about us? What does fear do to us? Do we install more security systems in our homes and cars? Do we build more gates or buy more guns? Do we save even more for retirement, pulling back from any charitable contributions to make sure that we have enough? Do we close our hearts? Do we close our minds to those who are different? The adult version of Matthew's nativity moves quickly from the glad moment of the adoration and gifts of the Magi to a darker, more ambivalent world of political intrigue, deception, and fear-induced violence. Matthew's account of the birth of Jesus is more sober, and it is also more realistic. We live in a world riddled by fear, a world of devastating superstorms and elementary school massacres, a world where innocents die every day, every hour, every minute. God's innocents die due to preventable illness, violence, and hunger. In Matthew's story of the visit of the Magi and the subsequent slaughter of the innocents in the verses to come, Matthew tells an accurate, if also difficult, picture of the world. And that is what is at the heart of Matthew's darker, more adult-oriented story of Jesus' birth. The promise that is precisely this world that God came to, this people so mastered by fear that we often do the unthinkable to each other and ourselves, those who God loves, this gaping need that we have and bear, this is what God comes to remedy. Jesus is Emmanuel, God with us, the living, breathing, and vulnerable promise that God chose to come and live and die for us as we are, so that in Christ's resurrection, we too might experience newness in life. Perhaps Matthew tells the story of Jesus' birth, tells the story of our lives with darker strokes, precisely so that we might perceive the glory and grace of God's redemption in Christ all the more clearly. Kind of like a bright star shining high in the heavens and leading us to greet our Savior and Lord. So today's gospel gives us two stories at the same time. We receive the invitation to bring all our gifts to the Lord by sharing them with those in need, to enter into the joy, the wonder, the awe, and also that even when we don't offer our gifts, when we hoard or covet or cheat or betray, Emmanuel, God with us, still bears the promise that God has truly seen who and what we are and loves us still, forever, through this life and into the next. Thanks be to God. Amen. Please stand as we confess our faith with the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, dwelling in the presence of God with us, let us boldly pray for the church, the world, and all in need. Draw into the light of God, we pray, for the proclamation of grace, the grace of Jesus Christ. Give us courage and boldness to go forth into the world to tell the good news of what God has done. Hear us, O God. Drawn into the glory of creation, we pray for the earth. Sustain every living thing with abundant resources, clean water, and sustainable harvests. Help us to steward all that you have provided. Hear us, O God. Drawn into the brightness of God's presence, we pray for the nations of the world. Reveal your compassion and peace for the sake of all who live in the shadow of oppression, violence, and fear. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Drawn into the light of healing mercy, we pray for all who wait for healing and relief of suffering. We pray especially for those whom we've named on our prayer list, for Kate Schaefer, for Tecumseh, for those who are grieving, especially the family of Tashonda Wade, and for all those we now name silently or aloud. Give us hope in the promise of new life where pain and suffering will be no more. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Drawn into the dawn of a new day, we pray for the ongoing reconciliation between people. Make us bold to name sin in our lives and to unite us in the promise of forgiveness and mercy. Hear us, O God. Drawn into the promise of everlasting light, we pray for those who mourn and give thanks for all the saints who now rest in the brightness of God's presence. Make us confident in our worship as we reflect the light of God with eternal praise. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Trusting in the presence of God by the power of the Holy Spirit, we commend all for whom we pray, dwelling in the light and hope of Christ our Savior. Amen.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Please exchange that peace with one another. God of all creation, all you have made is good, and your love endures forever. You bring forth bread from the earth and fruit from the vine. Nourish us with these gifts that we might be for the world signs of your gracious presence in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. By the leading of a star, he was shown forth to the nations. In the waters of the Jordan, you proclaim him your beloved Son. And in the miracle of water turned into wine, he revealed your glory. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." And so we are made bold to pray as our Savior taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. You may be seated.
Please stand. The body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. God of abundance, with this bread of life and cup of salvation, you have united us with Christ, making us one with all your people. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Amen. Don't forget to pick up the mail in your mailboxes out here, especially the newsletter. Go in peace, love and serve the Lord.